Right, here we go. Hello, everybody. It's me, Rob, and it's quiz time. Yes, it is Friday lunchtime here in the UK. It's 1:30. It's a lovely, sunny, hot day out there, and it's pretty hot in here as well in my little studio. So, yes, it's me, Rob, from BBC Learning English with the Friday quiz. Not Dylan today. Dylan's got a day off, so you've got me. So, welcome along. Thank you for watching. And here we go with today's live quiz from BBC Learning English. So if you're new to the quiz, don't worry, I shall tell you what's going to happen. First of all, we've got 8 questions to come, 8 questions to test your English vocabulary and grammar knowledge. And I'll give you the questions first, and then we'll have the answers later. Okay, questions first, answers later. Now, a lot of you say, what's the prize? What can I win? Well, you can win absolutely nothing. No, but it is just for fun. It's good fun to take part. It's good fun to test your English. And of course, you might even get your name mentioned here on the screen in front of me. So even though there's no prizes, this is just for fun, having a good time and testing your English knowledge. And don't worry if you don't get them right. It's just about having fun and having a go and seeing what you do know and what you don't know. I will give you the answers later on. Okay. Now, the most important thing is that you like, you comment, and you share. Yes. Give us a thumbs up. Send us your comments, either the answers to the questions or just your general comments about the quiz, and also tell your friends. The more people that get involved, the more fun we can have. Yeah. Is that right? Yeah. And also, it's good to know whereabouts you are watching from. So do give me a shout out from your home country, because I'm a little bit nosy and I like to know where you are. Okay, got that? Great. So don't forget, send me your comments because I'll get them here on the screen. Lots of comments coming in already for me to have a look at, which is fantastic. Such as we've got this one. Hello, Rob. Hello, Iwa. Hello, nice to see you. Hello from Poland. Hello to everybody in Poland. What have we got here? Hello from Italy. Hello, Italy. Good luck in the football tonight. But also good luck to Turkey as well. What have we got here? Hey everyone, glad to hear you all. Greetings from Barcelona. Hello in Barcelona. Hi to Kamfat in Laos. We've got people in Ukraine. Hello, Ukraine. Hi, Mohammed in Pakistan. What else have we got here? Carlos says, hi all. Yes, hello to everybody who's watching. Have you told your friends all about this? Najenda says hi from India. And what else we got? We've got good morning, Antonio. Good morning from Brazil, because of course it's morning over in Brazil, isn't it? It might be the evening over in Laos, morning in Brazil, lunchtime here in the UK. Amna, hello from Libya. Hi, Libya. And so one more for now. Lewis, hello from Colombia. Hello, Colombia. Great to know you are all watching. Okay, so it is quiz time. Between each question, I will ring this bell to move the quiz on. So, I've got 8 questions to come. Questions first, the answers later. And the important thing to tell you is today's quiz is all about travel. Today's theme is travel, something very close to my heart. I do love to travel. I'm sure you do too. Tell me, if we didn't have this silly pandemic going on, where would you travel to? Which country would you like to go and visit? It's a tricky one, isn't it? Because there are so many places. Anyway, today's theme is travel, and one of our questions will come from one of our special guests, somebody you know from BBC Learning English. Who might it be? He or she will be joining us later for a travel-related question. Okay. All right, I can hear you saying, get on with it, Rob. Come on, let's get on with a quiz. Yes, let's do that right now. Let's ring this bell and start with our first travel related question. Okay. Right. Let's move the slides on. Oops, didn't want that one, did we? We want this one. We want this one. Round one. Here we go for our first question. Have a look at this. You've got to fill in the missing blank. Can you see that nice and clearly? Here is your first question. It says, I'm something to London for my holiday. And your options are A, gone, B, going, or C, go. I'm something to London for my holiday. A, gone, B, going, or C, go. What is the answer? What is the answer? What are people saying? Let's have a look what you're saying. Shrishti says going. Okay. Fung says going. Jasim says going. Ib says B, so that's going. Mul says I'm going to London for my holiday. A lot of you are going for B. Is it really that easy? Are you all thinking it's B? Katie says B. Who else is answering now? What have we got? Habib says B. Are you absolutely sure it's B, going? And Naresh says B, going. I wonder what the answer is. I will give you the answer later on. Thank you, everybody who's commenting now. And do also tell me, if you weren't going to London for your holiday, where else would you be going to? Would you have gone to? Would you go to? Please tell me in the comments. Who else? What else are people saying on this quiz? Main says going. Okay. Abdu says going. Asif says going. Okay. So a lot of you think the answer is B, going. I shall give you the answers later on. Let's move on to round number two. Number two. And that is this round two. Here is your round two question. Have a look at that. Your question is, what do you do before you fly, before you get on a plane to go somewhere? Do you A, check in? Do you B, check out? Or do you C, checkmate? That is your next travel related question. What do you do before you fly? A, check in, B, check out, or C, checkmate? Wow, what are people saying on this live English language quiz? Right. Arena says A, check in. Alberto says check in. Okay. Edith says A, check in. Great. Princess Marwa says check out. Duan says A, so check in. Noen says A, check in. Okay, good, good. What else we got here? Coleaf says check in. A lot of you again think it is A, check in, but we've had a check out as well. What about checkmate? Mukesh thinks it's check out. Do you check out at the airport? Let's have another look. Maruz says check in. And Shirley says check in as well. Check in, check out, or checkmate. I will give you the answer later on. Just a reminder, this is the live quiz from BBC Learning English. We have 8 questions for you to try, and we have the answers later on. And we have a special guest with a question as well coming up very soon. But our theme today is all about travel. Do tell me where you'd like to travel to, and also tell me where you're watching from right now. Maybe I could travel there one day. Right, let's move on. Ring that bell, because it is time now to go on to our next question, round three. And round three is this question. Have a look at this. Do you know the answer to this one? Can you see that nice and clearly? Yeah. This weekend, I am going on a business, something to France. Let's make that a bit bigger for you. This weekend, I am going on a business trip to France, a journey to France, or a holiday to France. A business trip to France, a business journey to France, or a business holiday to France. That's our next question. Come on, what do you think the answer is for this one? Give me your answers. Okay, right. Julia says business trip. Tarakul says trip. Let's have a look. Carl says A, business trip. Business trip there. Somebody else saying business trip. Ashraf, A, business trip. Yosef, trip. Tasia says a business journey. Good try. Sayed says trip. You sure it's not a business holiday? Have you ever been on a business holiday? Could it be business holiday? Let's have a look. What are other people saying? Marie says business trip. What else we got? Mr. Laugh says a trip. Sveta says a business trip. And Rashad says trip as well. Trip, journey, or holiday? I will give you the correct answer a little later on. We'll have the questions first on this live English quiz from BBC Learning English. Thank you so much for watching. It's great that you're out there watching and commenting. Keep those comments coming in and don't forget to tell your friends about this quiz. Right, I think we should ring the bell. Here we go again for our next travel-related question. This is round four now. Question four, round four. Here we go. Can you see that nice and clearly? Question four is, on holiday, A, I go always to the beach. B, I always go to the beach. Or C, I go to the beach always. Yeah. Now look at that man relaxing on the beach there. That's exactly what I'd like to be doing. So I would say on holiday, I go always to the beach. I always go to the beach, or I go to the beach always. What do you do on holiday? Do you like to go on the beach, or do you like to go up a mountain, or do you go sightseeing? What do you do on holiday? Do tell me. But also tell me what you think is the answer to this question. Question number four. Right. Okay. Anwar says B, on holiday, I always go to the beach. Eder says, on holiday, I always go to the beach. Trang says, B, I always go to the beach. Okay. The right answer there is B. Okay. Musa says, C, on holiday, I go to the beach always. Come on, do you go to the beach always? Who goes to the beach on holiday? Let me know. B, or I always go to the beach. Sahil says B there. Apologies if I don't pronounce your name properly, by the way. I do try. All right. What else we got? Asif says B, I always go to the beach. David says B, of course. Maybe. Thopmeyer, B, I always go to the beach. Okay. Maine, I always go to the beach. Do you always go to the beach? Who goes to the beach? Come on, tell me. Okay, another B there. Abdul says, B, I always go to the beach. Right. Vikram says, B, I always go to the beach. Shanta says, it's polluted and crowded at the beach. I'm sorry to hear that, Shanta. Is that your local beach is polluted and crowded? That is a shame because the beach is a lovely place to relax. You don't want it to be polluted and crowded, do you? Right. Okay, let's take one more answer. Tebib says C, on holiday, I go to the beach always. Okay. Right. Fine. Well, I'll give you the answer later on, as I said. We've got four more questions to go. One of them from our special guest. Who will he or she be today? We'll find out soon. Right, let's ring that bell and let's move on to our next question, round five. Yes, question number five. And here is a spelling question for you. It's all about spelling. So, the suitcases and the bags you take with you on holiday is collectively called what? Is it A, luggage, B, luggage, or C, luggage? Yes, we know it's luggage, but how do you spell luggage? Is it A, Luggige? Is it B, Luggage? Or is it C, Luggage? How do you spell luggage? What do you think? A, B, or C? Right, let's see what some of you are saying in the comments. How do you spell luggage? Let's have a look. So Shaka says C, spelt with a double G there, as you can see. Miriam says C. Thotmeyer, sorry, I've got that wrong, is C. Somebody says B, luggage with one G in the middle there, L-U-G-A-G-E. Vipin says luggage with a double G, so three G's in total. That's C. Another C from Ali. Cecilia says C. Frank says C. Kamap says luggage. That's a C as well. And Sai says luggage. Lots of C's. Lots of C's. You're very confident that it is spelt with two G's in the middle there. Luggage. Hopefully you know what luggage is. I say it's all those bags and suitcases, your backpack, all the things you take with you on your holiday is your luggage. But how do you spell it? And a lot of you are saying C. Well, as always, I will give you the answer later on. Okay, later on. Right. We've got how many more? Three more questions to go. And one's going to be from a special guest. And guess what? We go to round six. And it is time to meet our special guest. Who is it going to be? Any ideas who our special guest is going to be for our next question?
Hey, hello.
It's Roy. Hello, Roy.
Hello. Oh, I'm not in the middle. There I am. It's quite dark here, isn't it?
What's your connection today?
I'm very well. I was just actually in the conservatory and it got so hot, my computer got too hot.
Wow. It is a hot day today, isn't it? Anyway, we were talking about travel. Do you enjoy traveling?
No, I love it. I absolutely love it. I love traveling. Absolutely love it.
What place have you been to in the world?
I've been all over. South Africa. I've been to Malta. I've been to Greece. I've been to Scotland. I've been to Brazil, Colombia. I've been all over.
Okay. Hard question, I know, but can you pick one of your favourite places? Do you have a favourite?
Honestly, there's so many that I love, but I have to say Brazil. I lived in Brazil for 3 years, and my wife and my son are from Brazil. So, I lived in Belo Horizonte, and there's some amazing places like Ouro Preto in Minas Gerais and Mata Atlântica in São Paulo. Absolutely stunning country, wonderful food, wonderful people.
Sounds great. I've been to Brazil once, and I went to a place called Parachi by the sea there. Beautiful place.
Near Rio, I think it's just above Rio,
Just south of Rio, yeah. Lovely
or
place.
Or Rio, as they say in Portuguese.
Thank you very much for the pronunciation. Excellent, Roy. So when you're traveling, tell me, are you the kind of guy who likes luxury travel, five-star hotels, being pampered, or do you like to put on a backpack and experience the simple kind of pleasures?
Of course, I love being pampered. I absolutely love being pampered, but I'm quite stingy.
I know that, yeah.
Hello. I'm quite stingy. I don't like spending money, which is what my question is about today. Okay, so if you travel somewhere very cheaply or on a small budget, we say that you travel on a trouser leg, B, shoestring, or C, top hat.
Good question. Can you give it to us one more time then?
No. Of course I can. Okay, so if you travel somewhere very cheaply or on a small budget, we say that you travel on a trouser leg, B, shoestring, or C, top hat.
Great question. Thank you very much. We've got a few comments coming here. So sorry if I sound distracted. I'm just looking for some more comments for you. Oh, look, somebody's been to Parachi here. I just found this message here. Somebody's been to Parachi. So I've lost your message now. It's disappeared. Never mind.
I should say oi to the bang to all the Brazilians, but all the countries I've been to, I have loved, and the people have always been wonderful in every country I've been to. And I'm always looking for new suggestions of places to visit.
Me too. So do tell us. You got any plans for any more travel? Maybe this summer, where are you going to go on holiday?
In a perfect world, if everything is okay, I would love to go to Brazil to see my wife's family and everybody out there. If not, I'm going to stay at home, have a staycation, and play video games.
Okay. What a holiday. What a holiday.
Very relaxing for me.
Yeah, absolutely. Right. Well, great. Thank you, Roy, for joining us. Thank you for your question.
Thank you very much for having me. Thank you.
Enjoy the rest of the day. Bye-bye.
Take care. Bye.
Okay. So did you get that for Roy's question there? Just to remind you, the question was, if you travel cheaply or on a small budget, you travel on a trouser leg, B, a shoestring, or C, a top hat. Right. What are people saying? Some people are saying A. So A is a trouser leg, traveling on a trouser leg. Alina says shoestring. What else we got here? Wales says A. So a trouser leg, traveling on a trouser leg. Yoko is guessing B. Mammal says, oh, maybe Brazil. What are you responding to on that? I'm not quite sure. We've got shoestring. B is a shoestring. Noy says B, shoestring. What else? We got lots of Bs, shoestring. Zeynep says C, which is a top hat. Ashraf says B, travel on a shoestring. What else we got here? Got an A there, a B. Thank you for all these answers anyway. I will give out the answers very soon. Got a B. Oh, the messages keep coming in. Thank you very much for giving this a go. Manuel says traveling on a top hat. Kareem says B, so shoestring. Maine says B, shoestring. Yeah, lots of Bs, but we've got some As. May says A, traveling on a trouser leg. This kind of informal English phrase, traveling on something. I'll give you the answer later on anyway. Okay, so thank you, Roy, for that. And don't forget, we do want your travel recommendations. Should we come and visit your country? Do let us know. Oh, look, Shanta says top hat, as in to walk under the sun. Okay. And what else we've got? Oh, lots of A's and B's coming in here. So thank you very much. Just to remind you, by the way, we are doing this live from my house here in the UK. This is the live quiz we do every Friday. Normally it's Dylan. Today it's me, Rob. And today we've got the theme of travel. So that was your question from Roy. That was round six. It's now time to move on to question seven, round seven. Here we are. Question seven. Oh, you can't see it. I apologize. There you go. Question seven, a travel-related question. Right. In London, using the tube is something convenient than driving. So in London, using the tube train, that's the train that goes underground, is something convenient than driving. So is it a lot convenient than driving? Is it more convenient than driving, or is it much convenient than driving? What do you think the answer is in this travel related quiz? Right. What are you saying? Well, let's have a look. Fernanda says B, more convenient than driving. Siempre says more convenient. Gavita said more convenient. Renit says more. Wong says B, so that's more. Iwa says question seven, more, I think. Okay. Ida says B, it's more. Sahil says it's C, much. It's much convenient than driving. Let's have a look. Kareem says more. May has changed her answer to C. I changed my answer to C, which is much, much convenient than driving. Musa says B, more. Okay. What else we got? Oh, come on. Up you come. Chinzia says B, more. Okay. Altaf says more. Okay. So a lot of you say more, but we've got some people saying C, much. In London, using the tube is much convenient than driving. Well, I will give out the answers fairly soon because we've only got one more question to go. Let's have a look. Much, got another much there. Okay, one more question to go. So let me ring my bell And we shall move on to question number 8. Round 8. Here we go. Your final question today on this travel-related quiz from BBC Learning English. And there it is. Can you see that? Number 8. Last weekend, I taken the train to Brussels. I took the train to Brussels. Or C, I take the train to Brussels. So it's I taken the train to Brussels, I took the train to Brussels, or I take the train to Brussels. This is what you did last weekend. This is, of course, fictional. In reality, we can't get the train to Brussels, not very easily at the moment, the capital of Belgium. It would be very nice, wouldn't it? Of course, from London, we can get a high-speed train normally direct to Brussels in 2 hours. Very nice, but not at the moment. Anyway, that is the question. Is it A, taken, B, took, or C, take? What do you think? Let's have a look. Okay, so Adriana says, Tokyo. Is that a recommendation of somewhere to go? Because I have been to Tokyo and I thought it was a wonderful city. Mohammed says, took. I took the train to Brussels. Sai says, took. Armin says, B, so that's took. May says, A, taken. Taken the train to Brussels. Last weekend, I taken the train to Brussels. Mawais says, B. What else we got coming up here? We've got a B there. A B, took. Sai, we've had Mohammed, B. Sai, took. Lots of Bs again. Tebid, B. Main B is took. I took the train to Brussels. Has anybody taken the train to Brussels ever? Do tell me. Do tell me. Another B there from Ejaz. Rahima says it took because it's past simple. I'll just quickly stick this one up. Mr. Laugh says it's coming home. The Euros is coming home. Yes. Are you excited about the Euros, which start tonight? Lots of European countries obviously taking part. Good luck to everybody who is taking part in the Euros. I'll just put this up. Ashraf is very confident. He's got all 8 correct. I haven't given the answers yet, but he reckons he's very confident that they were all right anyway. So good luck, Ashraf. It'd be interesting to know if you did get 8 out of 8. Now, Sahil, what do you think the answer is? Could it be took? Yeah, maybe, but only once, not 100 times. Thanks for your answer. Arena took. Good. Yeah, a lot of you saying took. Not a tuk-tuk, that little vehicle you go around in. It's took. Okay. All right. I think we get the idea. Yeah, a lot of you think it is took. Okay. There are our 8 questions. Now I'm going to ring this bell. This is the most exciting time to find out if you got the questions right. Okay. Reminder, by the way, if you've just joined us, this is our live English quiz from BBC Learning English. We have 8 questions. We've given you the 8 questions. It's answer time now. And we can find out if you're right or wrong. If you got it wrong, do not worry. We all make mistakes. If you got it right, excellent work. But let's find out, shall we, what the answers are. And I should give you a brief explanation as well. There is a lot more information, though, on our website. I'd be here all day if I gave you all the reasons and examples and things like that. But anyway, this is the quiz and here are the answers. So first of all, I asked you what the missing word was. And the question was, I'm something to London for my holiday, gone, going, or go. And of course, the answer was going. B, going. Were you right? Were you right? Yeah, the answer is B. I'm going to London for my holiday. This is all, of course, about the word go. Go is the simple form of the verb go. And then we've got gone, as you saw, gone, A there. Oh, not my bell over there. A. Gone is the past participle verb. I have gone, so you've done something in the past. But going, yeah, going, I think some of you said, is for the future. It's the present continuous. It talks about something that we're definitely going to do in the future. You've probably put it in your diary. Yeah, I always put my holidays in my diary. I am going on holiday. So it's something definite that's going to happen in the future, the present continuous. Okay, so did you get B right? Do tell me. Give yourself a big clap if you did. What else can I tell you? Yeah, basically, when you're going to do something, you're definitely going to put it in your diary if you have a diary. Okay, good. So who got that right? And where are you going to for your holiday this summer, maybe? Let's have a look. Well done, Iwa. Hurrah. 1 out of 8 so far. Get thumbs up to Gita. Hi, Trung. You're from Vietnam. Another lovely country that I've been very lucky enough to visit. Proposed to my wife in Vietnam many years ago. Thumbs up for Ashraf. Well done. Chinzia says, yes, that means you got it right. Excellent. Shatintha got it right. Well done. What's this, Maeen? Please say my first and last name and my country, Yemen. Reward me by saying hello, Maeen from Yemen. Is that right? Maeen Alamad from Yemen. Hello to you. Thanks for your comment. How are you getting on with the quiz? Ong says, too easy. Yeah, you may find some of these questions too easy. Not everybody finds them easy. But even if you did find them easy, it's good to know, isn't it, that yes, I knew that. I'm right. Absolutely no doubt I've got it right. So it's good just to confirm that you know your English well. So well done if you got it right. Hi, Divya from India. Well done. Hello. Another B there. Got it right. Correct. Well done. Where are you going on your holidays? Do tell me as well. I'm going to Scotland for my summer holiday this year, which should be nice if the sun shines. Okay. Got it right. Excellent. Yes. 1 out of 8 for Fernanda. Well done. Well done, everybody. You didn't catch the question. I'm something to London for my holiday. The answer was going. Chinzia is not going too far due to the pandemic. I think that's probably the same for many of us. And good evening from Vietnam. Okay, let's move on to the answer for question 2 now. Question 2. Yes. Remember this question. What do you do before you fly? Check in, check out, or checkmate? And the correct answer was check in. Check in. Did you know that was right? Yeah, check in. I'm sure you're quite familiar with the term check in. It's a phrasal verb, isn't it? And check in is when you arrive somewhere, probably an airport, to check in for a flight to get your boarding pass. You can also check in when you go to a hotel to tell them you've arrived and you get your keys. That's when you check in. It's a phrasal verb, to check in. You can also check out from some places, like a hotel. When you leave a hotel, you often check out, you pay the bill, and you give your keys back. You don't often check out from a flight, though, do you? You check in, you get on the plane, you go somewhere, and you get off, and you don't have to go and check out. And checkmate is really nothing to do with travel. I'm sure you guessed that. Checkmate is a term from chess, and I can tell you, I'm not an expert on chess, but checkmate is obviously a position where an attack that your opponent's king cannot escape from so that you win the game. That's when you're in checkmate, when you can't move your king anywhere. You're in checkmate. That's nothing to do with travel. That's to do with chess. The correct answer was check in. So how did you do? Let's see who got that right. Let's have a look. Dice has got 2 out of 8. So well done. 2 out of 8. For Najenda, well done. Yeah, Malak says A. Ida checked in when he went to London. Okay, good. On the aeroplane, I guess, yeah? Hey, you got it right. Well done, May. Check in. Well done, Malak A. Good, good, good. Khan's got 1 out of 8 so far. So we got that one already. I got it right. Yes. Marina A said check in, well done. Malak A, well done. I answered one, going to check in. Good, good. I did it right. Good. Diana's got 2 out of 8 so far. Well, this is great stuff. Don't worry if you've only got one right. It really doesn't matter. It's all about having fun and giving it a go on this live quiz from BBC Learning English. Let's move on and find out what the answer is to question number 3. Remember, I asked you this. What was the missing word? This weekend, I am going on a business something to France, trip, journey, or holiday. And the correct answer was trip. I am going on a business trip to France. Once again, this is slightly fictional. We can't really travel that easily these days. It's not very easy to go on a business trip to France. But anyway, this was my question, a business trip to France. Have you been to France? Which part of France? Paris? Marseille? Which part of France have you been to? Have you been to France? Do you like going to France for holidays? I think it's one of the most popular destinations in the world, I believe, for holidays. There's a lot to see in France. Do tell me, but also tell me, did you get it right? Right, let's have a look. Mudwali says 3 out of 8. That's good news. May also said trip. Let's get some more up here. Yes, I assume that means yes, you got it right. Good. Yilin says business trip. Yeah. Bumit's got 3 out of 8. That's fantastic. Sinzia has been to Paris and the Côte d'Azur. Wonderful. Fu's got 3 out of 3. I haven't explained why, have I, really? Why is it trip? Well, I guess a trip is a regular journey you make to somewhere and then you come back again. A journey itself, a journey is just a piece of travel, a journey you go on. Usually, you know, you do it once and you go there, a journey. A holiday, you can go on holiday to France. A business holiday is not quite right because business is about work and holiday is relaxing. So unless you love your work, then you can go on a business holiday. But really, you either go on a business trip for work or you go on a holiday to relax. And I say a journey is a piece of travel, but a trip is usually something you do to get somewhere and come back. So you might have a trip to the supermarket. I'm just going on a trip to the supermarket. You're going to the supermarket to buy some food, then you'll come back again. And here, a business trip is you're going to go to France, do some business, sign some contracts, do some deals, and then you come back again. And you may make that trip again in the future. So you go there and you come back. So the best answer really is a trip. So let's have a look at a few more answers, see how you're doing. What do you got? Oh, Emilio said, I went to Arequipa in Peru. I've been there. Beautiful city. Lovely. Great place for holiday. Okay, who's got it right? Okay, got a trip there. Wow, Sachintha. 3 out of 3. That's great. Yes, collocations. Okay, I see what you mean there. Yeah, Julia. I like France a lot. Yes, it's a beautiful country. May says I'm from Myanmar. So hello, May. That's where you're living. Myanmar. Fantastic. How are you doing in the quiz, May? Is it 3 out of 3 so far? Malik said A. Well done. What are people saying? I've got lots of comments coming in here. Hopefully you're going to share this with your friends. Saul says, I'm on a trip now. Where are you on this trip? Where are you? 3 out of 8. Fascinating. I hope it is fascinating. I hope you're learning something. Come to Mumbai, Santosh says. Well, maybe not today, but when we're allowed. Rashad says, A. He's got 3 out of 8. Well done up till now. Good. Good. And I like the look of your dog. Looks like a sheepdog. Thumb there's 3 out of 3 as well. So if you've got 3 out of 3, thumbs up. Good news. Excellent. But if you haven't, don't worry. It's all about having a go, isn't it? Right. Shall we move on now in our travel related quiz here from BBC Learning English? Question 4 was this. On holiday, I go always to the beach. B. I always go to the beach, or on holiday, I go to the beach always. What did you think the answer was? Well, the answer, correct answer is B. I always go to the beach. On holiday, I always go to the beach. That was the correct answer. B, is that what you said? Do tell me if you got that right. Now, let me tell you, this is all about adverbs of frequency. And the adverbs of frequency, so in this case, always, That goes before the main verb, which is go. So always and go. So the adverbs of frequency, which here is always, goes before the verb. So it's a subject, the adverb, and the main verb. Okay. If you want more details, there's lots about this on our website, by the way, at bbclearningenglish.com. So I'm sorry my explanations are quite brief, but just to tell you, there is the word always, and that always goes before go. I always go to the beach. That's the correct way to say it. If you did say on holiday, I go to the beach always, we would know what you meant. But the correct way is B. So how did you do on that question? Question number four. Hey, Ida says I did it right. Well done. Thunder says I'm incorrect. Question number four. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. I got all correct. I got not to worry. No, good. Don't worry. You got them all correct. B is the true answer. Yes, that's right. We've got 4 out of 8 so far there. So, yeah, well done. Long got it right. May got it right. Anna says, I did it right. Good. That's great to hear. Samira says, I am right. What else you got coming in here? Fernanda says, got it. There are exceptions to this rule, by the way. As I said, I'm not going to go into all the detail. It's all on our website. Right, what else we got? Let's have a look. Who else has got it right? B for Malik. And Karthik says, I always drink a beer at the beach. It is a nice thing to do if you drink alcohol, is to have a nice cold beer at the beach. Oh, that'd be nice now. Oh, do you know what? I might go to the beach tonight. It's quite a long way, though, unfortunately. I did it right. Well done. AK says 4 out of 8 so far. So good stuff. You are doing well if you've got 4 out of 4. But don't worry if you didn't. It's all about having a good time with this travel-related quiz. Ahmad says India. Okay, good. Right, let's have another look here. And what have we got here? Life is a long journey. People have to make it inescapably. Some wise words coming in there. May again. Sorry, May, I keep picking your name out, don't I? You've got 4 out of 8. So well done. Another 4 out of 8. Why isn't it C? Because always needs to come before the verb go. But it still makes sense. We still understand what you meant. And Vijayam says, second largest beach in our country is called Marina Beach. Good. That's good. What else? And Vikram was correct as well. Well done. Excellent. We're halfway through the answers on this live quiz from BBC Learning English. Here we go to the answer for question 5. Question 5 coming up. This is about spelling, wasn't it? The suitcases and bags you take with you on holiday thank you for spotting that typo, are collectively called. Because we're talking about lots of things, so it's are plural, isn't it? Are collectively called. So thank you for spotting that out. But the word we're looking at is the correct spelling of the word luggage. Luggage. What was the correct spelling? It was indeed the last one. C-L-U-G-G-A-G-E. Right. Luggage. This is the stuff you take with you, all the bags you take with you. Come on then, who said it was luggage? Who got that right? Do tell me. Inna says C, well done. Benny has 5 out of 5, well done. Nguyen says 5 out of 8, good work. And Dino says CCC, it was definitely C, luggage spelt like that. Malik says C. Rahima says C. Well done. What else we got? Great. Got it right, Alberto. Well done. Fantastic. Let's have another look. Snowbird says, I like baggage. That mean you like carrying baggage or having lots of baggage? I like to travel light myself. Rashad says C, got it right as well. Joan John says C, luggage. That's great. Maine says, fine. Thank you, my teacher. You made my day. You're very welcome. You're very welcome. My name is Rob, by the way, today, not Dylan. It's Rob. Okay. Good. C as well. So hopefully you found that one quite easy. If you found it easy, fantastic. If you didn't, it doesn't matter. It's all about testing what you know and what you don't know. And of course, as I said, there's no prizes. Right. Let's move on to the answer to number six. And this is the question Roy gave us. Roy came on earlier and told us all about how he loved Brazil. But he does it on a small budget. So when someone travels cheaply on a small budget, they don't spend much money, not just to be tight, but sometimes you have great experiences by traveling cheaply and staying in simple places. Anyway, we have a term for this, don't we? And this is A, trouser leg, or B, shoestring, or C, top hat. Well, we say it's traveling on a shoestring. Yes, we travel on a shoestring when we travel cheaply or on a small budget. Did you know that? And why do we call it shoestring? I guess because a shoestring is a very simple and cheap thing. It's a little piece of string that goes in your shoe. Not expensive, is it? It costs just a few cents or a few pennies. And therefore, when we travel on a shoestring, it means we don't spend much money. Okay, did you get that? Thank you, Roy, for that question, by the way. Let's find out how you got on with that one. Did you guess B correctly? Well, Cam's doing very well. Cam's got 6 out of 8, so well done. Kareem says, yes, you got it right. Well done. Yeah, great. Yi said B, shoestring. I got it right. Okay. Kareem got 6 out of 8. Well done. What else? Rita. Hi, Rob. You're great. Thank you so much. This is only my second quiz, so I'm glad it's going well. Yuva says she's fit 5 out of 6. She's sad because you didn't understand the question. I'm sorry about that. What does trouser leg mean? It doesn't mean anything, Ong. That's made up. The only correct answer is shoestring. A trouser leg is the one leg of a pair of trousers. So you have trousers, two legs. One leg is the trouser leg, but it doesn't mean anything in this context. It's just shoestring. Travel on a shoestring. We don't say travel on a trouser leg. That was a joke answer to try and trick you. Okay, Eric says, oh, I got it wrong. Doesn't matter. Got another 6 out of 8 there. Sorry, I can't pronounce your name. Hawan said B, shoestring, so you were correct. What else we got coming here? He says, what does it mean, top hat? Well, a top hat is a hat. A very tall, posh-looking, formal hat. People don't really wear them these days, but in the old days, gentlemen would dress up smartly and wear a top hat, a tall hat. But in the context of this question, it doesn't mean anything. We don't say travel on a top hat. Again, that was a made-up answer. The only correct answer is a shoestring. PB says, I got it wrong. Okay, never mind. My name's May. Oh, it's correct too. Good. Mayu. Okay. Mayu. Han says, yes, got it right. Good, good, good. What else we got? I sound like an ice cream vendor with that bell. That's very true. The men and women who go around selling ice creams go, yeah, ice cream, ice cream. I'd love an ice cream today. It's so hot in here today. Whew. Right. Mohammed says, B. Walker says, thank you. You're very welcome. I hope you're enjoying it. What else we've got? Bit random. Random question. Okay, maybe. Thank you for your support. Guatemala is a nice place. I would like to go to Guatemala. I haven't been there. And Mauritania. Hello from Mauritania. Hello in Mauritania. Thank you there from May. And hello from Bangladesh. Good, 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 good. How are we doing? English is the best popular language. It is a very popular language and widely spoken. So hopefully I'm helping you with your English. Super, well done. Valeria. Okay, well done, Valeria. Good, good. And hi from China. Brilliant. Okay, that's the answer to question number 6. Two more answers to come on this live quiz from BBC Learning English with me, Rob, today. ring the bell and move on to question answer number seven. Number seven, I asked you this. What's the missing word? In London, using the tube is a lot convenient than driving, more convenient than driving, or much convenient than driving. What was the correct answer? The correct answer was B. Did you get that right? In London, using the tube is more convenient than driving. And it's true. It is more convenient and it's quicker usually than driving in London, catching the tube train. So the answer is B, more. Okay. And I've got an explanation here. It's to do with comparatives, in case you didn't know that. Basically, when we're comparing two or more things, we use a comparative. And this is an example of a comparative. They help us kind of describe things and compare a person or a thing with another person or thing. So here we're really talking about traveling in London, and that one thing is more convenient. Convenient means easier, really, than something else. Catching a tube is more convenient than driving. Okay. So when we've got long adjectives, I suppose, like convenient, we use more to make them comparative. Okay. So long words, we put more before the comparative. Now, when I've got an exception here, because there's always exceptions, that if a word has just one syllable, I hope I'm making this clear. If it has one syllable, we usually just add ER to the end. So, for example, quick becomes quicker. Quick becomes quicker because it's a short word. But here, convenient, we say it is more convenient. Now, you could stress that by saying it's much more convenient. You're really stressing that it's more convenient by saying it's much more convenient. So you could have put C and then B. But for simplicity, the answer is more. The comparative word more goes before the adjective convenient. Did you get that right? Let's find out how you did. By the way, lots of exceptions, and it can be a tricky rule using comparatives. So do look on our website at BBC Learning English. Right, let's see how you got on with that one. Who got that right? Marie's got 7 out of 8 so far, so well done. Han says, yes, I am right again. Edith says, yes, I got it right. Who else has got it right? Oh, let's have a look at all these comments coming in thick and fast. Thank you so much for the comments. Cam said B, so you were right. Santosh has got 5 out of 7. Somebody called Lego Films is cool, got it correct. Right, Amain says that you got it right. You got 7 out of 8 and you're waiting for your prize. So here is your prize, your name on the screen. But will you get 8 out of 8, I wonder? Samira was right. Richard, I got it right. And Chinsia says it was okay for me. So that means you got it right. Okay, fantastic. Ewa says 6 out of 7. Can you also say more comfortable? Yes, more comfortable. You could, in this example, I suppose, say that. Yes, in London, using the tube is more comfortable than driving. If you find being in a hot car, stuck in traffic, uncomfortable, then you could say using a tube is more comfortable. So well done for that. Okay, let's move on to our final answer. And this is going to be the answer for question 8. Our final question, when I asked you, last weekend, I something the train to Brussels. I taken the train to Brussels. I took the train to Brussels. Or I take the train to Brussels. And of course, the right answer was, I took train to Brussels. I took the train to Brussels. How did you do on that question? And have you been to Brussels? Nobody has told me they've been to Brussels yet. Do tell me if you've been to the capital of Belgium, to Brussels. But do tell me as well what your final score was. Now, of course, the answer is took, as I said, and this is an example of a verb that's got 3 different forms. Now, take is an irregular verb, so it's got 3 different forms. Let me just list them for you. The infinitive is take, the past simple is took, and the past participle is taken. Now, in this example, we've used the past simple, haven't we? Took, which simply describes something you did back in the past. Now, the word take, of course, has many uses. You can take something off a shelf, can't you? But here, we use it to mean use a particular type of transport. So if you take a train, take a plane, take a bus, that means you're using that type of transport. You're not actually grabbing it and taking it. It means you're going on it, you're using it, okay? Now, as I said, this is an irregular verb. take it is an irregular verb, and we've got other examples like break. And you can say it broke or it was broken. There's another example. But here we take, and we've got taken, or simply took. Past tense, you took the train. It's what you did last weekend, not this weekend or next weekend. Next weekend, I will be taking the train to Brussels. Today, I took the train to Brussels because I've just done it. Okay, so it's took. The answer is took. Again, we have lots of explanations about irregular verbs on our website. Right, so who got all the answers right? Who's going to be our clever clogs today? Let's have a look. Okay, you think it was a piece of cake. What a great phrase. Piece of cake means it was really easy. Ho says it was B, correct. Cam says 8 out of 8, full marks. I won it, Mr. Rob. Your smile is our prize. Thank you very much. That has made me smile a lot. 8 out of 8 for Cam. Mae says, oh, I got it wrong. Doesn't matter. Hopefully you've learned something there. 6.5, that's a funny score. Tan says it was an easy one. Okay, good. Ashraf says, all passed. Well done. Chinzia says 7 out of 8. Well done. Emilio took his bike to the beach. I took my bike to the beach. It's something you did in the past, but you might do it again in the future. Rahima, yeah, 8 out of 8. Well done. Faraz got 5 out of 8. So well done, and well done for having a go. Junkie from Nepal got 8 out of 8. So well done. We've got a thanks from Sao Paulo. So thank you very much for watching. Dee agreed with me that it took because it was written last weekend. It was past simple. That's correct. Ahmed says 8 out of 8 from India there. Well done. And who else? Anybody else got 8 out of 8? Evgeny got 8 out of 8. Well done. 8 out of 8 in Colombia. Can you imagine if you got 8 goals in a World Cup? Wouldn't that be good? Santosh, good. Well done, Santosh. Khan, I was right. AKS, what is Brussels? Well, Brussels is the capital city of Belgium. Brussels is also a vegetable, but we're not talking about that. Brussels is the city, the capital city of Belgium. Sabah says 8 out of 8. And who else has got 8 out of 8? Any others? Armin says, thanks for the quiz. I wish we could hand you some biscuits. Well, that would be lovely. Thanks, Armin. Nice thought, anyway. I shall go and get my own biscuits now because we have reached the end of today's quiz. I do hope you've enjoyed it. You've enjoyed taking part. You've enjoyed the questions. They weren't too hard and they weren't too easy. They got you thinking about English a bit. We're going to put this quiz back on YouTube so you can watch it again and again. And please share with your friends. And just a reminder, we do other live lessons across the week. We have pronunciation on Tuesday and Thursday, and we have live English lessons on Facebook Live on a Wednesday. And we have lots of material to help you with your English on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. So do go there for more help. Okay, well, my name has been Rob. This has been BBC Learning English for our live Friday quiz. Dylan will be here next Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Have a great weekend. And we shall see you all very soon. Thanks for watching and well done for taking part. Cheers, everybody. Bye for now. See ya.